Coach, first of all, welcome to Big Orange Country. I know you're excited to be here, but it's been really hectic back and forth and fast-paced, hasn't it?
Very, very fast-paced. You know, you get enough time to lay your head down at night and just get a quick battery recharge, and then you're running again.
All right, talk about the last month for you, because you've been juggling really two and three balls up in the air, haven't you?
Yeah. Well, you know, got an opportunity, thanks to everybody here, Coach Jones and everyone that let me continue, you know, coaching those kids through the Rose Bowl. It was the right thing to do. You'll see that's kind of how our staff is here. I mean, we pour everything we have into our players. It's about the players, and it's not about me. It's not about my career. It's about coaching young men, and I take that job serious, and so does my wife. And to bolt out on those young men before the granddaddy of them all would not have been the right thing to do. So we finished it through, and again, real appreciative of everyone letting me do that here and being tolerant of that. But the second that clock ticked zero, I was putting an orange shirt on, hitting the road, running for Tennessee.
But it was pretty special coaching in the Rose Bowl.
Oh, my goodness. I had tears coming down my eyes running out of that and just that venue. And I called Coach Jones, and I said during that week, I said, Coach, if this isn't motivating, you know, I've coached in a lot of bowl games, but I'm like, Coach, we got to get to one of these now. So it was very motivating.
Your association with Coach Jones goes back a long way. I mean, you played for him, didn't you?
Yeah, he was a player when I was a coach. In 1998, he became the tight end coach at Central Michigan. I was a senior, so yeah, I got to be around him for a little while, a young Butch Jones.
What did you learn from him as a player under him back then?
You know what I learned from Coach? You know, he didn't directly coach me as a wideout, but he was right there on offense, so I got to be around him every day. Coach Jones was always very, very polished, very professional. You know, he wasn't like some of our other coaches that you know, might have, they seemed a little frazzled at times. He was never like that, and I always respected that about him, that he was always, everything was well thought out, well planned out, and you know, he was a lot, we had a lot of the same personalities like that, and as a coach, I said, you know what, if I'm ever a coach, I'd take some things from him, so I kind of learned that.
How much has his philosophy changed from then to now that he's a head coach?
I'm sure it's changed greatly. I mean, the foundations are probably still there, but you know, the style of offenses and what he believes in. Every year you learn as a coach, we're all pirates, we're all stealing from each other anyway, and finding out what works, what doesn't work. But one thing he taught me is, hey, we're gonna go out and research the way everybody does it, and if one of those ways could help us and fit in with what we do, we'll use it. If not, it just gave you more knowledge on things. And he's always pressing us to never stay still, never be comfortable. I've learned that from him a great deal.
When he called and said, we want you to come to Tennessee with us, what was your reaction?
You want, really?
Yeah.
I put the phone down and started fist pumping and then gathered myself and said, well, I appreciate the opportunity, Coach.
Let me think about it. Okay, yes.
That's right.
One of those deals.
That's right. Yeah, I had some other opportunities, but this one was a no-brainer for me. The staff really, you know, besides for it being Tennessee, and I mean, I coach at wide receiver U. For a wideout coach, that does it get any better, you know? And I was really excited about that. But this business is about people. You can't run a great organization without great people. And I knew the staff he had put together, because it was all done by the time that I got an opportunity. And that part is what drove me to jump on that plane.
Now, you've seen Tennessee from the other side of the field when you were coaching in Florida. So talk about just Neyland Stadium, the atmosphere. You know a lot about it now.
Yeah, it was my first SEC game, and I'll never ever forget it as long as I live. You know, I love college football. I'm a fan as much as I am a coach, and just the pageantry of it all, and driving up Neyland Drive there on the buses, seeing the Vol Navy. I've never seen anything like that. And I got out, and right when I got out, I mean, there's people just, you know, obviously surrounding all the way down to the tunnel, and this old lady, she probably about 8 years old, had a Tennessee, and she said, hey, she looked at me, she goes, Florida stinks. And I'm like, I mean, she was as old as my grandmother, and I said, okay, yeah, all right, here we are.
You got a feel for the passion.
I did. So it was, and obviously the stadium and everything speaks for itself, so it was an amazing experience.
All right, now you got to kind of rebuild this receiving core a little bit. Talk about the job going forward.
Well, we got a big job to do. There's no doubt about it. We've lost some quality key guys in those roles. Not many left. We got to get some more numbers right now, number one. We're deficient in just our numbers of wideouts that we have. So this recruiting is going to be crucial. And unfortunately, we're kind of getting in late on some kids and trying to build quick relationships and convince them that we can do it and I can do it and all those things. So we got to rebuild from a recruiting standpoint, number one, and just get enough people in here to do what we need to do. And then number two, just the guys that it's great. I got a bunch of no-name guys. That's kind of what I've been jabbing them at. Hey, no one knows you guys. I mean, they've known the guys were here last year, and I might even nickname them that for this season just to give them a little bit of an edge, because that's what it is. But it's neat because it's kind of a blank canvas, you know, for me to work on. I don't have to worry about bad habits because they really didn't get a lot of chance to play. I mean, they did a little bit. Some of them did a little bit, but not really, really play. So that getting the culture and the mentality of what I want, what Coach Jones wants, what we want as a staff, I think is the first part of rebuilding this thing. The technique and the fundamentals, that's going to come. It's getting the mentality of what we want, and that's going to be that's always a huge undertaking. It always is when you go from one, and unfortunately I've done it quite a few times now, but it's also fun. I also like that. I take the challenge. That's what keeps me up at night.
Big job, big challenge, but also big expectations.
Huge.
And that's what you want.
That's what I want. I mean, you know, I coached at Valparaiso University starting out, making $4,000 a year, sleeping on the floor, painting the field. I'm not sure we had three people at our games. You know what I mean? So, this is why you work. This is what you want. You want to put your product on the field in front of everyone for everyone to see if you're a competitor. And that's what I want. I want to jog the wideouts out, and I want them to feel like they're the best trained receiver corps in the country. And I want people to press play and go, that's the best receiver corps in the country. And I don't want there to be any gray in that. It's either this or this, and we're planning on being this.
Zach, thanks for your time.
Yeah.
Good luck. It's good to have you
here in
Tennessee.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Coach.
All right.